The state of the ozone layer around the Earth is a good news, bad news situation in 2012. Here at the Florida Society of Dermatology and Dermatologic Surgery meeting in Orlando, Drusilla Hufford of the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency tells us why.
It's actually really good news because scientists believe that the ozone layer is going to recover in 2065. It's a little bit of a bad news story, though, because 2065 isn't today, and there are still American children growing up in neighborhoods all across the country and all over the world who are actually being exposed to more UV radiation in the past. So it's particularly important that the dermatology community continue its great collaboration with all the other public health specialties to try to make sure that parents and young children get the message about being safe in the sun.
It's an anomaly where the ozone hole was actually bigger in 2011 than in a lot of years in the past, but overall you're still optimistic about the health and the future of the ozone layer.
Very much so, because what happened in 2011 actually was a peculiarity of the meteorological conditions in Antarctica. I think it's actually even conceivable that very large ozone holes will recur in the future, probably several times. The good news, though, is by 2065, scientists believe that the ozone layer will return to the conditions that obtained before the human interference from things like the ozone depleting substances. So yes, I think long term, I'm very optimistic. Short term, I think it's going to be important to continue to take the kinds of precautions outside that I know so many folks in the dermatology community are trying to emphasize for patients.
So it's way too soon to take your guard down in terms of sun protection.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. All the slip, slop, slap, and wrap, those are all still really important for people to be aware of. They need to be safe in the sun, especially for kids, because as you know, and as I know this community knows, it really makes a difference to keep people protected when they're young.